Welcome back children to my channel. Today we start with class 12 poem Aunt Jennifer's Tigers. Now this poem, it is written by Adrienne Cicelrich, who was born in Baltimore, Maryland. And she was not only a poet, but she was also an essayist, a theorist and a feminist. And she is also one of the most widely read and influenced poets of the second half of the 12th century. And in this particular poem which we are going to read, she has tried to explore the inner feelings of a woman who is living under the dominance of men in her married life. Now, before starting the poem, let's go through its summary so that it is more clear to you. Now, this poem, it is through the eyes of Auntie Jennifer. And this Auntie Jennifer, it is the poet's auntie. And if you can understand that indirectly, the poet is trying to express her own feelings through Auntie Jennifer. And Auntie Jennifer, she tells about her inner desires to free herself from the clutches of abusive marriage and patriarchal society. And the poet, she addresses the constraints of a married life a woman experiences. Now, in this poem, the poet is trying to tell about the ladies or the housewives who have to face abusive marriages in this highly male-dominated society. And remember, this poem, it is based in America, but since those times, it used to happen there also. Now, as in the poem, the aunt Jennifer, वो बैठकर वो embroidery कर रही है. She is embroidering a design of a lion, a tiger. Tiger who is very fearless. As you all know, the tiger is full of energy, full of freedom. But aunt, she has to live a submissive life as per her husband's command. She has to do whatever her husband asks her to do. And she is always in fear. उसको हमेशा डर लगा रहता है कि कब मेरे हस्बैंड आ जाएं और कब मुझे ये नहीं करने के लिए कहें. शी इज एम्ब्रॉयडरिंग, वो एम्ब्रॉयडरी कर रही हैं. उनकी जो निडल है, वो निडल भी उनसे अच्छे से नहीं हो पा रही है, बिकॉज शी इज फियरिंग. एंड लेटर ऑन वी रीड इन द पोएम दैट दो शी इज ओल्ड बट येट शी इज फियरिंग हर हस्बैंड एंड शी इज नॉट एबल टू एंजॉय द फ्रीडम विच अ टाइगर एंजॉयज इन द फ्री जंगल और इन द फॉरेस्ट. नाउ she is even afraid of doing the embroidery and she fears his wrath and torture. And since the time jab se uski marriage hui thi, tab se she has been fulfilling the demands of her husband. And later on is explained in the poem that she has got a wedding ring on the hand, as when you get married you have a wedding ring. But that wedding ring usko hamesha yaad dilati rehti hai ki she is belonging to her husband. She is just a thing to the husband. And this burden of this demanding marriage, it is totally exhausting her. उसको थका रहे हैं, उसको mentally torture कर रहे हैं. This agony, this pain, this torture, she says it will continue even after her death. उसकी death हो जाएगी, जब वो मर भी जाएगी तब भी जो ये ring उसके हाथ पर होगा, इस वजह से वो कभी भी free नहीं हो पाएगी. But the design of the tiger which she is embroidering, it will continue moving around freely, proudly and gracefully. And so her desire, her wish, uski jo ichcha hai, Auntie Jennifer ki jo ichcha hai ki wo bhi freely ghumna chahti hai, fearlessly ghumna chahti hai, elegantly without the tension or the torture of agony. She wants to live a life. So after her death, it will move on through the tiger. So now let us do the understanding of the poem paragraph wise. Now, as you see, the first paragraph, it explains Aunt Jennifer's tigers prance across a screen, bright topaz denizens of a world of green. They do not fear the men beneath the tree. They pace in sleek, chivalric certainty. Now, as you all know, Aunt Jennifer, she is embroidering on a piece of cloth, and that piece of cloth, it can be a tablecloth or a wall hanging or anything. And the pattern, this shows that tigers tigers, they are dancing or moving or jumping. Prancing is something which you're moving freely and all over the fabric. Means here she's trying to say the tiger, it is moving freely in the jungle or in the open world of green. Green means forest, jungle mein wo ghoom rahe hain. And here the bright topaz, it is used as a metaphor for yellow color. Topaz, it is a precious stone of yellow color, and she is saying to tiger ka color hai, that is bright yellow, and he is moving freely in the world of green. And this dense green forest, it is the background. That maybe she is having a green color in the background, and the tiger, it is bright yellow of the topaz color. And these tigers, they do not fear the men beneath the tree. Means they are not afraid of anything. They are fearless, they are moving fearless, and they pace in sleek chivalric certainty. Sleek is elegantly they are moving, just like a gentleman's grace. Chivalric, it is concerned with how a gentleman it moves around. So the tigers, they are moving in sleek, in elegant gentleman's way in the forest, free, without the fear of anybody. Which, unlike, now here we have a contrast between Aunt Jennifer and the tigers. The tigers are both fearless, but Aunt Jennifer, who is embroidering them, she is not fearless, but she is full of fear of her husband. So now she is a lady, as you must have right now known, that she is afraid of the husband. Now in this first paragraph, if you can see the literary device, the rhyming scheme is AABB. You can say AA and here BB. And another thing which they have used is anaphora. Anaphora means when the same word, it is repeated in the two consecutive lines. Like you can see they. They do not, they pace. And metaphor, as I told you, the metaphor is here bright topaz, which is used to describe the bright yellow color of the tigers. Now let us move to the second paragraph. Aunt Jennifer's fingers fluttering through her womb find even the ivory needle hard to pull. The massive weight of uncle's wedding band sits heavily upon Aunt Jennifer's hat. Now here fluttering is moving. Now Aunt Jennifer, what she is doing, she is moving through the womb, means she is embroidering, but her hands, they are fluttering, they are trembling with the fear of the husband. She has got this hobby of embroidering, but in the free time she likes to embroider. Unke khali samay mein unki wish hoti hai ki main embroidery kare, but because of the fear of the husband, jo unki needle hai, she is finding it hard to pull it out from the cloth. So this line, it explains that how fearful she is of her husband. Unko kitna dar lagta tha apne husband se. She is afraid ki pata nahi kab wo aa jaye aur kab unhe scold kare ki aap ye faltu ka kaam kar rahi hain, this embroidering is nothing useful. So she is very afraid, and her fingers, they are so tired, and it reminds that she is very very afraid, and she is very tired of working endlessly in her life. Full life unhone work kiya hai as per the commands of the husband. So now she is feeling very tired. And how? Now there is one very important line, the massive weight of uncle's wedding band. Massive weight is the weight of the wedding ring. Wedding band means the wedding ring. Uncle ka jo wedding band tha, uncle ka jo ring tha, it feels like a weight, a bhar, a bahut hi bada bhar, which she is feeling immensely in her life. It shows the dependency of Aunt Jennifer on her husband. It sits heavily upon Aunt Jennifer's hand. She is burdened. She is highly burdened by the weight of the ring. And it is just like an entrapping. It is a trapping which has been fallen on upon her because of the virtue of being married. So I think you can understand that she is just like a property to her husband. वो अपने हस्बैंड के लिए सिर्फ एक प्रॉपर्टी है. शी इज जस्ट अ थिंग टू हिम. She is not a wife. She is just a property and she is living a demanding life due to the torture of the husband. So now you can very well understand in this second paragraph the fear of Aunt Jennifer. So now in this paragraph, the literary device is again AABB. The rhyming is here again AANBB, and here we have used alliteration. Alliteration here is F sound. You can see fingers fluttering, F and F, fingers fluttering. So this is the alliteration. Now let us start with the third paragraph. When aunt is dead, her terrified hands will lie still ranged with ordeals she was mastered by. The tigers in the panel that she made will go on prancing, proud and unafraid. Now she is saying that she wants to live. She wants to live a free life. She wants to live a life which is free from the torture of his husband. But she can't do. She can't do, and she says that when she is going to die, in the old age also, when she is still now in old age, and when she is going to die, her hands, on her hands, and how are the hands terrified? On her hands, this ring will stay there, and it will signify all the ordeals. Ordeal means all the pains, all the tortures, all the agony. Jitna bhi dard unhone saha hai because of the husband, and she was made to order everything, and she had to follow the orders of the husband. All this thing, it will still remain after her death. But all these tigers which she has embroidered on the cloth, they will move around freely, moving around freely in the green world, proud, unafraid, fearless. But it is the irony of her life that she will be tied with the shackles in the form of the ring, and this ring was the proof that what tortures she had suffered from her husband. So in this paragraph, the literary device are, the rhyming scheme is again, you can see AA and BB, and in the alliteration you can see the P word, you can see prancing, proud. This is the alliteration which is used. Now we go to the question answers, and you can see how do denizens and chivalric add to our understanding of the tiger's attitude. The word denizens, they means that they are proud of their home, they feel safe there, and they have a feeling of belonging attached to it. The word chivalric shows that they have a majestic and worthy position like knights. Why do you think Aunt Jennifer's hands are fluttering through her womb in the second stanza? Why is she finding the needle so hard to pull? So as you know, she is fluttering, her hands are fluttering, wo dar rahi hai, because she is scared of the husband who can come any time and he can scold for wasting the time. And that's why her needles, it is very hard to pull out because fingers, they are tired of working endlessly. Then, massive weight of uncle's wedding band. What do you understand by this? It suggests symbolically that the bindings and the obligations of her marriage are so much that they have put a lot of burden and stress on her. Jo ye wedding band hai, means a ring hai, it symbolizing all the bindings, obligations and the loss of freedom. And aunt is terrified. Who is aunt terrified of? Naturally, she is terrified of her husband. Now, what are the ordeals Aunt Jennifer is surrounded by, and why is it significant that the poet uses the word ringed? What are the meaning of the word ringed in the poem? Now, ordeals, the different pains, the tortures which she is going, is first she is obeying the husband's order, then she has the fear of men, then she is giving into dominance and the fulfilling his command. She is never saying no, wo kabhi bhi mana nahi karti hai, always she is accepting what he is demanding. And here ringed means entrapment, means वो totally, totally trapped हो चुकी है marriage के अंदर, and that marriage is not a good one, but that marriage is of a torture one. So just like the ring, it is encircling the finger, similarly the husband has encircled her in the clutches, and her body, soul, they're all trapped, and she is struggling from freedom. and fearlessness. Now, and why do you think Aunt Jennifer created animals so that are so different from her own character? Now, naturally, she wants freedom. She has this intense desire for freedom and fearlessness. And this is coming through her creativity. And she's expressing her thoughts through the embroidery. And those tigers, just like the tigers, she wants to move freely and fearlessly. And so difference, it is shown that lady is not what she is. She is meek. She is sitting under the dominance of the husband, but because of the circumstances, she has to do so. But she also wants to lead a life of respect and right. Now, what are the different symbols which are found in the film? For example, denizens of a world of green. It means inhabitants of the forest. Massive weight of uncle's wedding band. It means the burden of marital obligations. Then sits heavily upon aunt. It means it has laid a lot of stress on her. And ringed with audience, it means to get entrapped in hardships and sufferings. And the last is, do you sympathize with Aunt Jennifer? What is the attitude of the speaker towards Aunt Jennifer? Yes, we all sympathize with Aunt Jennifer, and the speaker is also sympathetic towards her and hates dominating. So I hope you have understood this poem.